We'll now have a speech by Mr. Kappaganthula Padmakar, Director HR, HPCL, Mumbai.
Very good morning to all of you. Actually, this place has got seniors of all vintages and then people who are extremely talented in different fields. And probably I am not a fit guy to stand here and speak in front of you. But nonetheless, out of the deep humility to all my teachers who are sitting here and all my seniors, as well as many of the people who have assembled here over the years, I stand in front of you and then speak to you. I attempt to say a few words in terms of what I have been told to speak is about the perspectives on school life. I have personally gone through four schools, two schools in Secunderabad and two schools in Chennai, and then finally the one that leaves its lasting impressions on me has been Kesari High School, Mylapore. And I passed out, I joined here in the year 1974 and passed out in the year 1977. And we had the honor of being taught by many of the teachers who are sitting here. And I was very grateful to hear two of them even happened to remember me, even though 40 years have gone by ever since I passed out. I must say a few things coming from my heart in terms of what the school has done to me. I never used to think much about myself. People used to say that he's a bright boy and then he scores, but then I used to mug up things, what they used to say called take things by heart and then reproduce, and I used to get good scores. But that story ended when I came to Kesari High School, Mylapore, and some of the teachers who I'm told are unfortunately no more here. So they are the ones who challenged us in standard 9 when some of my classmates are here. And suddenly, to our horror, we realized we didn't know a thing. We didn't know the basics of English. We didn't know the basics of Telugu, basics of science, basics of mathematics. And this is one of the very few bold schools which never claimed itself to be very modernist in its approach. It never made any tall claims at all. It was one of the many seen as very ordinary schools, but they took a very bold step of taking a pause in the syllabus for something like 3 months and taught us the very basics, and thereafter they resumed the syllabus. I never understood the impact of what that would do to me, but one thing that happened was I have learned to understand what it means to go to the basics of things, understand the root of a particular thing, and then thereafter develop on the theme. So over a period of time, the guy who used to mug up quite a bit and reproduce, and mind you, I was very good at that. So from there, I shifted gears into trying to understand the conceptual learning of anything, go to the basics of things, and try and figure out and try and build more on that. That is one of the few things this school has done to me. And thereafter, wherever I went, the foundations that this school has laid in me has made me grow to greater heights. If today I'm able to speak English standing in front of you, as well as write or do many things, it's the fundamentation, it's the foundations and the fundamentals which I got from this school, to which I'm extremely grateful to all the teachers who have been here, and some of them are sitting here, so my heartfelt thanks to all of you, sir. And this is one school which also taught us many things very quietly. I developed hatred for many subjects in some of the schools I studied in Secunderabad, because the method of teaching was take a cane or a duster and then put it on your knuckles, and obviously you don't develop any love for it. But this is one school, somehow, though they never said much about things, extremely gentle, and there was nothing called a corporal punishment about which you keep hearing about so much. We didn't have anyone like a school counselor, but the teachers themselves were the school counselors. And they knew each one of us what we stood for, and they knew how to tap into us so that we could grow up to our own potential. So that's one of the beautiful things about Kesari High School, Mylapore. So though it's 40 years since I passed out in 1977, when the call came from Srinivas and company that they are planning a get-together here and to honor the faculty who had taught us so many years back, I was one of the first ones who said that I will come, come what may, and postponed some of the meetings which my chairman had with me in the company, and I said, this is very important to me, and I'll come back on Wednesday, and thereafter we can do whatever meetings we want. They say education system teaches us many things, but one thing I have learned from this school is what simplicity can do in terms of your own education. You don't need to stand from the rooftops and scream that I am an egalitarian school and so on, or I teach you horse riding or many other things like what many international schools do today. But ultimately what matters is if the teachers, who to me are like parents, because once we step away from home, the next 10 to 12 years, the time we spend is only in a school. And the kind of teachers and the quality of teachers matters quite a bit, because then they are only next to your parents at home, who probably don't have all the time in the world to teach you, so therefore they send you to school. And it is these teachers who assume the role of parents and bring us up. And unlike parents at home who bring up probably two or three kids say for their lifetime, these teachers seem to bring up at least 50 to 60 students in each section. And God knows in an academic year, probably 100 all students they bring out. So put together cumulatively, I think they have taught thousands of students who have spread their wisdom all across. I think my deep humble salutations to all of you here, sir. And Madam Ramanamma Garu was telling me in the morning about wherever we go, how we should take forward our own core cultural and ethical values, and there is nothing further from the truth from what she's saying. And I told her that ultimately wherever we go, it is only these simple ethical values that we learn from the schools that is what stays with us. It stays with us in our subconsciousness, and whether we like it or not, that's what pops up and makes us go forward in anything that we do. So to me, the schools are the ones which build a whole lot of capabilities in us. They sow a whole lot of deep seeds in terms of our interest, be it science or mathematics or literature or any of these things. And much later, they take shape and give vent to multiple things. And I'm told many of the students here are also into cultural activities, they are also into music. A whole lot of them have flowered into good sound professionals. If not anything, most of them have evolved into excellent human beings. And I think that is where this school has helped all of us in terms of being where we are. So I do not stand between you as well as the seniors who are sitting here. I'm here to convey on behalf of all of us. So the story I'm telling is not just about me. It's true to all of us who are sitting here. And we convey our deep, humble salutations to all the teachers and to this school, which has not changed one bit. Over 41 years I've seen, even the restrooms seem to remain the same. And sometime back there seemed to be plea for funds. I was wondering, why is it there cannot be an open-ended alumni fund where all the alumni can chip in any amount that they think that they are capable of chipping in on an annual basis or whenever they feel like. So please start an open-ended fund and we would all be glad to chip in to the best of our abilities. But also do allow the alumni to come and say a few things. And I'm sure many of us are very wise and very erudite here. So if you think your pass percentage is 48 or whatever it is, I think many of us can come here, step in for you, and also teach the children who are studying here. Now this is one thing I'm making an offer from myself, though I'm Mumbai based, but I presume many of my friends sitting here who are Chennai based, they would reciprocate with these kind of feelings. So my humble and earnest request to the school authorities here, I don't see some of them who spoke here, they seem to have gone off. So can you please listen to us and start an open-ended alumni fund, and perhaps also dip into the talent that most of us have here to take the school management as well as the school to greater heights, and to teach all the kids who perhaps need much more than what the teachers do here. So that's an open-ended offer from all of us on behalf of all the alumni associated here. And I do hope that the school authorities will take cognizance of this and work on it very, very soon. And thank you very much for giving me a great opportunity to stand in front of you. Like I said, many of you are more talented than me and more accomplished than me. It's only that I am a symbolic person standing here and speaking on behalf of all of us. Thank you very much, and it's a great honor and pleasure to be here. Thank you.